We are back with more Scarlet Nexus. I was stuck in the new OS, the old OSF hospital that looks surprisingly new. Where do we go from here? Do we investigate more on the way out? Sounds like there are doors opening. There are? We should absolutely check out the doors. It's like a shiny new facility.
Lend me your eyes.
Here you go. Hey. Got to focus.
Now die. Go.
And you be tell.
Yeah, I knew they were hiding something there. So the government's not gonna trust us after this? Oh, we're in a separate facility. Nope, in the hospital.
Major General Karin?
Yuito, it looks like you've finally become a traitor too.
What do you mean?
Did the new Himuka government brand Yuito a traitor?
Yes. I doubt you'd be allowed inside Suo. Come to Seiron. You'll all be accepted as one of them.
You're asking us to help Seiron? The same people who are sticking human brains inside others?
Meanwhile, New Himuka is conducting experiments to metamorphose humans all in the name of producing a strong power. And at its center is the great city Suo.
They're both twisted. They're both crazy.
Then what do you want to do? run to the religious fanatics in Togetsu? They're a religious state. They'd probably be open to taking in criminals such as yourselves. But Togetsu won't necessarily be a safe place this time around.
This time?
Just a figure of speech.
Yeah. New Himuka won't be able to get us in Togetsu. They're an independent city. It is a little shady, though.
Is that why you came here, Karin? To tell us this?
It was just an afterthought. However, take this if you're going to Togetsu.
I can't drink this. I won't.
Whether it's human blood or brains, you need to drink it if you want to live. Either way, you'll lose all your memories and powers if you choose to do nothing. The drugs are simply giving you time, so you have to drink it whether you like it or not.
He's up to something. But what is it?
Most likely saving Fubuki.
Should we be helping him?
No. Come back to the hideout. Major General Fubuki wanted me to tell you not to worry about him. Besides, I can at least monitor his status from here. Come back, so we can make a plan on whether we're helping him or running to Togetsu.
All right.
Karin's ampule. Huh. Alright, are we in the standby phase yet?
Hey, good job, everyone. Man, this unit's so cozy.
Wataru! What are you doing here?
I had a meeting with Major General Fubuki. I was supposed to escape to the hideout if they found out you guys snuck into the old hospital in Lokusho. I mean, I can navigate you anywhere as long as I have a PC and Synet.
Which means that Fubuki predicted Yuito would be branded a traitor.
So, he told Wataru to come here, since he is Yuito Platoon's operator.
If they're going to make Yuito the bad guy, it makes sense to take out the person who knows what Yuito Platoon is up to. Good thing Wataru got here when he did. Otherwise, they may have subjected him to personality rehabilitation.
Yep, that's basically it. I made sure they didn't know where this hideout was before I left. This was originally a unit for the Sumeragi family. It'd be bad if Chief Kaito found out we're here. But it seems like we're fine for now.
I haven't told my brother that we're using this unit, but we should be careful. We own many others, so I don't think they'd find this place right away. In any case, I can't believe my brother made me into a traitor.
Yuito.
It's really made it clear to me that he sided with the government. Not that I didn't already know that.
Anyway, since I'll be staying here from now on, rest assured that nobody will find this hideout. More importantly, do you still have the thing Major General Fubuki gave you?
I have it, right here.
What is it?
It's for Arahabaki, a one-time use key code generator.
Why would he give something that important to...
Major General Fubuki entrusted the key code generator to you because he thought he might not come back alive.
Have you heard anything from him?
I've tracked him leaving the old OSF hospital. He completely disappeared from all systems after that. I hope he hasn't been captured by the government.
My brother saved Fubuki. I'm sure of it. We have nothing to worry about.
That reminds me. I wonder if it's true that former Major General Karin and Luka were both duds.
I'll look for him on my end, too. Besides, you guys don't have the luxury of worrying about anyone. They're calling you demons and hypocrites in Suo. Our stocks are limited. If you don't make contact with Togetsu or Seiron soon, we're gonna run out of supplies.
How could they do this? They were just hailing him as a hero.
It's fine. They shouldn't have been calling me a hero in the first place. There's actually something I wanted to tell all of you. It seems that I was born without powers.
But You have powers. What are you saying?
You know how I was being treated at the old OSF hospital as a kid? Seems like I was subjected to an experiment that caused me to acquire my power. I think the reason why my powers have been on the fritz lately is because they were artificially engineered. It probably puts a huge strain on my mind.
Are you sure you're okay with telling us this? That you used to be a dud?
Oh, is he sensitive about having been a dud? I mean, hiding it doesn't change the truth. And I figured you all deserve to know, considering all the trouble my unstable power caused you.
It's no trouble, really. Yeah, we're just worried about you. It's only natural for us to worry.
But thank you for telling us. I've heard there are many people without powers who live their life suffering in secret.
It's sad, but I do believe that is the case.
And if something ever happens, you know we have your back.
Thanks. All right. We should rest here a little bit and figure out what to do next.
Arahabaki passcode generator. Standby 7.
It will probably be impossible to recover Nagi's memory data now. I guess this means Major General Fubuki's plan will have to be put on hold.
Is he in here too?
So you were admitted to this hospital when you were little as part of an experiment on duds? I can't believe they locked kids in a hospital to experiment on them. Must have been scary. That's unforgivable.
I don't really remember it, but thanks for worrying about me.
So you don't have bond stuff, do you?
So I'm a rebel. I can't believe Suo was after me. I don't know if I should go to Togetsu or Seiron, but what Seiron is doing is unforgivable.
Oh, nothing with Wataru. Bond episodes. So I guess we're gonna do the Bond stuff this episode too, or this week. Let's see. Alright, but we're missing one for her. Yeah, she's got one. Okay. We've got a couple. 1,000. Oh, Eight. Max Jelly? Okay. Solid. Drone controller. Pendu analysis. What's a Pendu? No. Okay, so there are no new gifts to give out. So I guess we'll just do a bunch of bonds. Oh yeah, we have messages. Let's check the messages first. Who messaged us? New training missions? Okay. Seiran and Togetsu. Wataru, okay. Religious nation located on Hino Mountain. You know who you're up against. So we're going to Togetsu. Update notification. and Shinden. All right. Cool. Yep, Bond episode time.
Hey, Gemma. Are you free right now? Do you want to go somewhere with me again? Gemma?
Sorry, I was just thinking.
Is something the matter? I'm here if you need to talk.
Yeah, maybe I should talk to someone. One of my friends who retired from the OSF has gone missing.
Are there any leads?
I first learned about it when I got a message from his younger brother. We hadn't talked in a while. He asked me if I might have any ideas, but I couldn't give him any. I was just wondering what to do now.
I can see why you're worried. Is there anything I can do?
No, I can't trouble you with this. It's a personal problem.
But I want to help. Why don't you just tell me what you can? It couldn't hurt.
Thank you. I'll take you up on that. The friend who went missing was an old classmate, and then we worked together in the same platoon when he was still in the OSF. But as the years went by, the anti-aging medication's effects weakened, and his body began to age. It's something all children of the state have to face eventually, but he reached his limit sooner than me. His powers waned as he aged, and fighting became too difficult. He retired this past spring.
I see. I'm glad he managed to retire safely and not get hurt or die.
Yeah, but children of the state face a tough situation after retirement. The body ages normally after they stop taking the medication, but the abuse their brains sustained over so long a time is significant. Many retired soldiers deal with various issues, stemming from their body's changes exacerbating their brain's fatigue.
It's that tough for them? Can't they treat that with medication?
I hear there are many who receive treatment, but it's not easily cured. If it becomes prolonged, it also affects the patient psychologically.
Do you think your friend wasn't feeling well after retiring?
Yeah, he was tired, physically and mentally. I tried my best to stay in touch after he left, but after a while he just kept asking me about the OSF and my missions. It seemed like he wanted to come back. He missed his old job after having trouble adjusting to retirement.
I mean, he was with the OSF for decades after all. It's tough to instantly change your life.
He never wanted to retire to begin with. Those who can no longer fight will never be able to return to the OSF. I decided to distance myself from him, so he can finally move on from the military and build a new life for himself. I didn't reply to his messages or meet up with him. Looking back now, I was probably too harsh. His brother said it was cold of me to cut off all contact like that. I can't blame his brother for saying that. It might be my fault he disappeared. Maybe I pushed him away when he needed me the most.
You did it for your friend's sake. You can't blame yourself for that. For now, you should do what you can. Have you tried calling your friend?
No, I haven't reached out to him yet.
Then try messaging him. Even if you don't know where he is, it should reach him if he's safe. Maybe he's just waiting for you to contact him.
You're right. Waiting here won't get me anywhere. I'll take your advice and do whatever I can. There's no reply.
He might need time to notice the message. Let's wait a little longer to see if it reaches him.
Or it reached him, but he's not planning to reply. There's no way for us to know. Back when we were in the OSF together, we could easily brain talk with each other and had GPS to know our location.
Yeah, that's not available since he retired. He has to go through the trouble of accessing a terminal.
I can't really relate how inconvenient things are after you retire. But he must have been going through a lot.
Yeah. Why don't you keep messaging him and wait to see what happens for now? I'll see if there's anything else we could do.
I'm glad for your help. I'll let you know if I learn anything.
Okay. Poor Gemma. I never really thought about what people do after they retire. Is there anything more I can do? I know. The OSF database could have information on Gemma's friend. The data's locked. I guess that's not a surprise. Wataru, you got a sec?
Yo, what's up?
There's an OSF matter I want you to look into whenever you're free.
OSF? So information that can't be found through official channels. Okay, send me the info. I'll look into it.
Thanks, Wataru. I hope we find a lead on Gemma's friend.
Interesting. I can't settle down. Huh. All right. Where is... Nope. You know what? Let's go out and see what Shinden has to say. Right, and there's a team bond level that I need to be looking at too.
You're late again, but it's fine. I forgive you.
Thanks. So, what do you want?
I have some things to say about the way you fight.
The way I fight?
Yeah. I've seen you fight many times, and you have a lot of wasted movement. You're no longer a cadet. If you want to call yourself an OSF soldier, don't just flounder around. On the battlefield, you need to always be reading your enemy's movements and consider your next move. Use your brain.
So he calls me here to criticize me? What the hell is he thinking?
Hey, are you listening? I'm spending my precious time on you here.
Hang on. I don't really know what's going on. Why did you want to talk?
Because you helped me before, however slightly. I'm returning the favor by giving you some advice.
That was advice? Sounded a lot like you were making fun of me.
What? You can leave if you don't want my advice. I thought you'd want to get stronger.
He's annoying, but he has been in the OSF longer than me. If he really wants to help, I guess I'll listen. All right, I'm all ears.
A wise decision. You can't win without hard work. Though I'm sure that doesn't make sense to someone who was born with a silver spoon in his mouth.
He can't stop with the insults. I bet he doesn't have any friends.
Back to the subject. I told you to read your enemy's movements, but it must be hard for an inexperienced rookie to do that. Instead of relying on hazy knowledge, it's better to work on reaction time and calm decision-making skills.
I see.
Unfortunately, you lack both right now. It's a miracle you're still alive. Was it incredibly good luck, or was it your teammates? If you don't want to die young, you need to get better.
I listened to you, and all you did was insult me. You hate my guts. Any reason why?
What? I go out of my way to help you, and you think that's an insult?
Come on, that last bit was definitely an insult.
Fine. I'll tell you if you really want to know. I haven't liked you since the first day I met you. Since I was scouted, I worked for years to get strong. I've been near death more times than I can count. How could I like someone who was born in the Sumeragi family and pampered his whole life?
Who my family is doesn't matter. I'm my own person.
No matter what you think of yourself, everyone else only sees the Sumeragi boy.
That may be true, but... That's why everyone was prejudiced against me, even though I worked so hard. But if I say that, Shiden will have a field day with it.
If you don't like it, you have to become strong enough to surpass your name. But if you can't listen to advice, it'll be impossible. The fact that a volunteer soldier like you made it into Captain Seto's platoon had to have been because of your family connections.
What?
Another thing I hate is those dolls you guys collect. That little packin' or whatever. What's cute about such a weird little thing?
There are some things you just don't say. It's Baki, not packin'. That's rude to Baki. What's with you anyway? You're just spewing insults now.
What? You're the one who complained when I was just trying to give you advice.
That wasn't advice. It was just nagging and insults. I've had enough. I'm out of here.
Fine.
What's with him? Did he actually think that was advice? It's like he's made of insults. Next time he calls me, I just won't show up.
Interesting. Now we have Hanabi, and maybe we'll do Hanabi last this time. I wonder if we'll get the other party members at all, or if we're stuck with our separate group. Because Archie's cool. Like, their whole team has cool people.
I've added new functions to version 1.1 of the Forced Break program. It's a system that teaches you simple relaxation methods when you enter rest mode. Now give it a try.
I didn't come here to test this, Arashi. Why don't you quit developing this program?
You came all the way here to tell me that? What a waste of time. You should have just refused when I invited you.
No, I think it's important for me to tell you this.
I'm all ears for your elegant speech, oh great one.
It's not like that. I just don't know about forcing a break through a program. There are easier ways to help people relax. You could offer to listen to their problems or give them some advice.
I see. I'll have to explore those options. Why don't you tell me about your problems then, Yuito?
What?
I'm taking your suggestion. You have a lot of pent-up feelings because of all this hard work you're doing, right? So, out with it.
I don't know where to start. Like, my family and brother?
Chief Sumeragi? That's a bit of a touchy issue.
Yeah. I had no idea he was involved in something like that. He even set me up as a traitor. My dad didn't tell me anything either.
I understand your confusion. Although I can understand why the chief did what he did.
Does that mean you approve of their methods?
I didn't say that. I don't endorse them or forgive what they did. However, the way they're willing to sacrifice their own family if necessary is something I can see myself doing.
Would you be able to do that to Major General Fubuki? You could sacrifice your own brother depending on the situation?
I would, but he wouldn't be able to make the same decision. For better or worse, he's still a child. You two are similar in that way.
What's that supposed to mean?
Children think they can save everyone, but that's not how reality works. There will always be something that needs to be sacrificed. Grown-ups have to figure out the line to draw on what to give up.
I think you hate being that kind of grown-up.
Is that so? Well, you might be right. If I stayed a kid, I might be happier thinking I could do anything. Being able to selfishly slack off whenever I want is something a grown-up gets to do. Pretty cool, right?
No, grown-ups shouldn't slack off.
You really are so much like him.
Interesting. So all of these bond things are going to culminate in missions, probably. Character quests or something like that.
What's the matter, Hanabi? Why are you sighing? Did something happen?
Oh, Yuito. No, it's nothing.
Come on, you can tell me. We've known each other since we were kids.
Yeah, you're right. Thanks. So, the other day when I was battling an other, I accidentally burned a building that was nearby, and Gemma scolded me. He said that my control of my powers was rough, and I'd eventually end up hurting those I need to protect.
He doesn't mince words.
He's right, though. I wasn't paying enough attention. Gemma asked me what I wanted to be as a member of the OSF, and to think hard about what I'm fighting for. The thing is, I still can't picture what I want to strive for.
Right. You did mention that you never thought about what you wanted to do in the OSF.
Yeah. And the things we've seen since joining, you know, the suspicious secrets and inhumane experiments, just awful things that ruin that image I had of the OSF as a kid.
That's true.
After finding out that the organization we're in caused a lot of suffering to so many people, I can't picture anything positive when someone asks me what I want to fight for as a member of the OSF.
I understand that feeling of disappointment, finding out this isn't the organization you thought it was. But you're the one who's out there fighting. You just need to figure out what you're fighting for as an individual, not as part of the OSF.
My reason for fighting. I'm not sure if I have one.
I bet you'll come up with something if you think about it. I mean, if there's no reason, then why have you been fighting by my side all this time?
It's because you...
I what?
Nothing. I'll try thinking about it some more.
Okay, but there's no rush. I'm always here if you want to talk.
Thanks. It's not like me to doubt myself like this. Feeling sad won't change anything. All right. I'm going to find a reason to fight.
Yeah, that's the spirit.
Thanks for cheering me up.
You were always cheering me up when we were kids, so it's my turn now.
You don't owe me anything, but I'm happy to hear you say that. Thanks for listening.
Sure. Just let me know if there's anything I can do for you.
Don't worry. I will.
Huh? You're flushed. Do you have a fever?
What? No, I was just admiring...
Admiring what?
Oh, like you and everyone else? I was hoping I'll always be with all of you.
Bond 5. SAS. Burn negation. Huh.
I feel like you really trust me.
Of course. I trust you the most.
Alright, gift time. What do we have? What's this?
Thank you.
It's gonna be a while for everyone to have all their junk.
This is very nice.
No, because nothing
this is for
wrong.
Me. I guess I don't need to mention it, but you don't avoid me.
I have no reason to. Do other people avoid you?
Yeah, the youngsters probably feel awkward around an old man like me. I'm used to it, but it can still hurt, so I'm grateful.
Bond 4. Assault Vision. Nice.
This is what it means to trust each other.
Yeah, I trust you to have my back.
Thanks, Yuito.
For what? I didn't do anything.
When I see you working so hard, it makes me want to work hard too. I think I've matured a little, but it's not enough yet. I'm not just going to follow after you. I'm going to get better than you and pull you up to my level. So you better be ready.
Oh, that's maximum bond. Flamethrower and enhanced pyrokinesis. These are flamethrower. Fifth combo hit. What? Baki doll.
I have your back. I promise I'll get stronger so I can protect you.
Then I've got your back. Let's get stronger together.
Books. Oh, this.
Oh, thanks.
So yeah, we're gonna give gift for a minute. All right, observation journal. Sure. Those are easy to get. She's maxed out. Alright, so where is... Well, you went up, didn't you? Yeah, I have assault vision. So for Luca. Oh. I guess we can't do much with Luca yet. Yeah, he has it already.
This is very nice. You're working very hard, Yuito.
You think so? Thanks.
You're gentle, earnest, and straightforward. It makes me a little jealous. I can't be like you, and I don't have to. But I still recognize your good qualities.
Level 3. Recovery speed of teleportation. Luca up here and then attacks the enemy continuously.
I'd like to get to know you even better.
I was actually thinking the same thing. I think we can be better friends.
Hold on, let me get the big gift again. There's some grinding for me to do off camera, but I'll take it. Hanabi hand weave basket. What do I need for it? Gift exchange ticket. Battle simulation. Ask other ecology. Kunad Highway, I can do that. Phantom Sand Hourglass. Huh. Oh, these don't count. Okay, hold on. What's about Tsugumi? Might be able to get a level with everyone in here.
Really? I'm so happy. Sorry to bother you, but can we talk?
Yeah, sure. Did I do something? I mean, you're pretty observant.
Well, you always take care of me and the others, right? You should take care of yourself, too. I'm worried you might dry out.
5. Longer duration on the clairvoyance. Okay.
I know how you feel. I hope you know how I feel, too.
Great. Don't worry. I know how you feel, even if you don't say much.
Can't go back there or there. We can go to the hospital and Rasubi. We'll pick up this quest and we'll call it a week, I think. Yeah.
Looks like someone is in trouble near you. You might want to find them and talk to them.
Talk? All right, got it. Is that the only one? Alright, back to the hideout. Not bad. We took care of the standby stuff, and we took care of getting out of the old hospital. So I'll explore that old hospital on my time. And then when we come back, we'll go to Togetsu.
Oh, Yuito! Here, this is for you. It's nothing special.
Maybe do some simulations, we'll see. But until then, thanks for joining me for more Scarlet Nexus. And I'll see you guys next time for Phase 8. Catch you later!